Hello learners, welcome to another session. In this session, we are going to understand more about the grammar translation method as a method to teach foreign languages. When it comes to Indian settings, English is the basic foreign language which is being taught and it is taught at a grand level. So we all need to understand and appreciate that how English can be taught in different manners. Why English is being treated as a foreign language? Because it's not a native language of Indians. So, it's a foreign language, but an accepted language in our country, and we need to really develop methods because it's a language which is being used at a global level also. So, there are different particular procedures for accomplishing or approaching something to enable the learning. Now, we need to understand that when it comes to methods to teach the foreign language, what is a method? What in essence is a method? Because if we understand what is a method, we will be able to understand what different methods can enable the teachers to do in the classroom. Method is a particular procedure for accomplishing or approaching something, especially a systematic or established one. Method means the principles and the techniques employed to teach a foreign language. Here, for this session, the method is meaning that it is the principles and the techniques which are being employed to teach a foreign language. What are principles? Principles involve five aspects of second or foreign language teaching. What are those five aspects? It's the teacher, the learner, the teaching process, the learning process, and the target language or the culture. Now, why we are using the word target language, oblique culture? Because language never comes on its own. Language never comes in a vacuum. Language always brings along with itself a culture to itself. So, if you are learning English, the English culture is also coming inside. If you are learning French, the French culture is also coming inside. Now, there are different methods to teach the foreign language. But in this session, we are going to talk about the grammar translation method. But before moving further to understand what grammar translation method is, let us just understand that how did these methods of language develop? What are they influenced by? Methods of language teaching have been influenced by a variety of extant social, political, and also psychological factors. Let's just list down some of them. The number one factor is the need of the society at a particular point of time. This is one factor which really determines the kind of method which you are going to use for teaching a particular language. So, if I have to take English to a large audience, my method is going to be different. But if I have to take English to a small audience, my method is going to be different. Second factor which influences what kind of method is going to be used is having an understanding of what language is. As earlier said, if you understand that language is just not language, language is language plus culture, your method is going to be determined by that. If I am understanding that language is language plus culture, my method is going to be different. But if I am taking language as just a technical thing, my method is going to be different. Then the third factor which influences the same is an understanding of how children learn. There is a laid down procedure of language acquisition. Language, we generally think that the mother tongue or the mother language comes in, it just comes like that. You do not need to do anything for the same. But something is happening at the child's level. There is an understanding, there is a basic procedure which is being followed. The teacher may not be doing that, it may be happening at the home level, but it is definitely happening. But if the teacher is able to understand and appreciate that how children learn, she will accordingly use the method. If she thinks the language acquisition is a natural process, her method is going to be different. If she thinks that the role of teacher is important here, her method is going to be different. Now, having understood what the method is, what a particular method is, and also the different factors which determine the kind of method we are going to use, let's just move further to the main topic of the session, which is talking about grammar translation method, also popularly known as GTM. Now, what is GTM? The grammar translation method was the traditional method which was used by Latins and Greeks when Latin and Greek were taught in Europe. So, Latin and Greek for Europe were foreign languages, and this GTM method or the grammar translation method was used for the same. In the 19th century, it began to be used to teach modern languages also, such as French, German, English, and this is a method which is still being popularly used in some countries, depending on which language is being taught. Probably it's one of the oldest methods used for teaching language. It's a method of foreign or second language teaching which makes use of translation and grammar study as the main teaching and learning activities. Please go through this definition carefully. That one, that it's a method of teaching a foreign language. So it's not a method which can be used for teaching your native language. For teaching a native language, the methods are different. But when it comes to foreign languages, the methods are different. So grammar translation method is one method which is used to teach the foreign languages. One, that it is used to teach a foreign language. Secondly, it makes use of translation and grammar study as the main teaching and learning activities in the classroom. So the focus here is on translation and the grammar study. Now, what is the purpose of grammar translation method? Number one purpose which it solves is it helps the students to read and appreciate foreign language literature, because you are exposing foreign language to the students. So the students will be able to read and appreciate the foreign language literature also. Second, it helps to study the grammar of the target language. The target language here means the foreign language or any language which is being taught through the grammar translation method. So in Indian settings, it's going to be English if we are talking about the English, or it could be some other language also. So if the basic purpose behind using the GTM method is to study the grammar of the target language. The third important factor which is termed as the purpose of the GTM method is to better understand the grammar of the native language through familiarity. So your understanding of your own language, your understanding of your own grammar gets better if you are using the GTM. Then to speak and write their native language better. Moving further, intellectual growth through grammar exercises. So it's not just a language is being taught, it is bringing an intellectual growth also through certain kind of grammar exercises. It depends on the teacher that what kind of exercises she is planning in the classroom, but the grammar translation method is aiding to the process of intellectual stimulation also. Now let's just see that what are the different aspects of grammar translation method. We are going to start with the characteristics of the teaching learning process in grammar translation method. The first characteristic being translation from one language to another. So you're translating English to probably the native language, which may be the Hindi here. Secondly, it's enabling the study of culture and literature of the target language community. Now, what is the target language here? It is the English. So target language community would be the British. So English, when we are studying English, it is enabling the study of the culture also and the literature also of the language, target language community. Then further, characteristic of the teaching learning process of grammar translation method would be that a deductive study of the grammar would be done. The rules would be taught. They will be followed by a practice of rules. So focus is on grammar. Number one, rule, and second is the practice of rules. General rules first and the particular rules secondly. So focus moving from simple to easy. You're doing the general rules first and then you're moving to the particular rules also. Then another characteristic of using grammar translation method in the teaching learning situations would be grammatical paradigms memorization, such as verb forms or conjugations. Then memorization of the vocabulary list. So this is last characteristic but not the least characteristic, because all these characteristics are entwined to each other. So the use of grammar translation method also leads to memorization of the vocabulary list in the classrooms. Now to understand the grammar translation method, we also need to understand the different aspects which are involved with the grammar translation, or for that matter with any kind of method. Now let us see how a foreign language is viewed if we are using the grammar translation method. When we are using the grammar translation method, the foreign language or the literary language is considered superior to the spoken language. The literary language means the written language here is considered superior to the spoken language. So So, written English is considered superior to the spoken English. Then, there is focus on teaching only the language of literature. So, focus moving is moving towards the teaching of that particular language. Thirdly, the culture of the foreign language community is imparted through their literature and art. As earlier stated, language never comes on its own. Language always comes along with its culture. So, if you're using grammar translation method, you're using the language to bring the literature and art of that language community also into that setting or into that country or into that classroom where you are teaching that particular language. So, if I'm talking of the English language, we are bringing the English literature also and we are bringing the English art also into the classrooms. Now, you've seen that how language is being viewed. Now, let's understand the role of students' native language when we are using grammar translation method. Because we always need to appreciate that English is a foreign language in this setting. So, the native language would be the mother tongue of the child. In generally, it is Hindi when it comes to the Indian situations, but it may be the regional languages also. So, the language of classroom interaction between the teacher and the students would be the native language. Now, when we are using the grammar translation method, remember the language of classroom interaction between the teacher and students would be the native language of the students. The native language is used for understanding and translating the foreign language text. So, what is happening here is the native language will be used to understand and translate whatever is being given in that foreign language text. So, probably the teacher would read a paragraph from the English book and then she will explain that English paragraph in Hindi or whatever language, whatever native language is of the classroom in that language to the students. So, translation is also happening and understanding is also happening because without that understanding or without that translation, the student would be able to understand what has been said in that foreign language text. We have seen that how language is viewed by the classroom. We have seen how the native language is being treated when we are using the grammar translation method. Now, let's see what is the role of teacher in the grammar translation method. The teacher is playing a traditional role here. She's doing the job of an authoritative kind. She's supposed to be the provider of knowledge. Students do what he or she asks them to do. So students do not have that kind of independence here in these kind of methods because it's the teacher who is supposed to have the know-how of the language. So she's the one who is traditional, who is authoritative, and she's the one who is dictating or telling the students what they are supposed to do. So students do not exercise that kind of freedom in the classrooms when the grammar translation method is being used to teach the foreign language. We have understood that what is the role of the teacher in the grammar translation method in the classroom. Now, let us see what is the student-teacher interaction in the classrooms. Now, here in the grammar translation method, most of the interaction is teacher-student interaction, but they are not playing the same role here. It is actually teacher to student interaction which is happening in the classroom. So, it's a teacher who is doing the dominating task and it's the student who is probably on the receiving end. So, teacher is the provider, teacher is the giver and student is doing only the receiving task. They do not enjoy too much of freedom in the classrooms. They are the ones who are playing a more submissive role in the classroom. There is little or no student-student interaction which is being provided for in the classrooms. So, remember grammar translation method doesn't just discourages the student-teacher interaction, even the scope of student-student interaction is very limited when we are using the grammar translation method. Why? Because coming back to the basic premise, it's the teacher who knows all the things. So, your co-fellow or your peer students also do not know much. So, there is limited scope for student-student interaction. In this kind of method, no pair work is there, no discussion is there, no group work is there. Because it's a teacher who knows and it's the students who do not know. So, you cannot make the two do not know group to work together. So, it's only individual work which is being done in these kind of classrooms. So, one can imagine the kind of student-teacher interaction which is happening in these classrooms. Then, within this category, we also need to understand that the feelings of the students are not dealt with. They are not understood, they are not appreciated, they are not dealt with. So the teacher is not worried that whether what kind of feelings the students is developing when this particular method is being used, whether the student is at times understanding also or not, because she is the one who is dictating the things here. Whether the student is feeling at ease with that method or not, it doesn't matter to the teacher. Now, gone through the role of teacher, gone through the role of students, or probably the student-teacher interaction which is happening in these classrooms or in the classrooms where the grammar translation method is being used, let's understand what kind of language skills are emphasized when we are using the method of grammar translation for teaching a foreign language. Following skills or following language skills are emphasized when we are using the GTM method. The number one is vocabulary. Number two is grammar. Number three is the reading skills. And number four is the writing skills. Grammar, we all know that without grammar or without vocabulary, one cannot appreciate the foreign language which one is learning. So to enable that, we need to have vocabulary, we need to have grammar, and both these are being emphasized when we are using the grammar translation method in the classrooms. When it comes to the reading skills, it is the emphasis is on the literary text reading, not on any other kind of text, but literary text reading. And when it comes to writing skills, the focus is on comprehension questions and composition writing. So comprehension is going to be there, a comprehension passage is given, and from that passage several questions are developed and the student is supposed to solve that kind of thing. Or there may be that kind of arrangement or that kind of activity could be there, that certain incomplete sentences are there and the student has to make a composition from the same. Or probably there is a picture which is given there and the student have to compose based on that. So only these two kind of writing skills are emphasized when we are using the grammar translation method in the classroom for teaching a foreign language: vocabulary, grammar, reading skills, and writing skills. And within writing skills, it's only comprehension questions and composition writings. Moving further, let's understand how the evaluation or what kind of evaluation is being done in the grammar translation method. Focus is on the written test, and the written test are focusing on translation from one language to the other. So the kind of innovation is not expected in these classrooms where GTM is being used. The written tests are going to be there, and written tests are focusing only on translation from one language to the other. There are questions about the foreign language culture also, which are there in the evaluation scheme of the classrooms where GTM is being used. Why such questions would be used? Because we know that English is taught, English is being taught, it's just not English, it's the language along with the culture which is coming here. So if you're teaching French through the GTM method, which is being done in many schools or many classrooms of the Indian setting, so the questions are there going to be not only about the composition or not only about the French grammar, the questions are there going to be about the French language culture also. Moving further, there are questions on the application of the foreign language grammar rules also. So it's not just that the knowledge is being provided, certain kind of understanding and reflection is also expected from the students. And so the evaluation pattern would have certain kind of questions which would need application of the foreign language grammar rules also. I hope you have got a thorough understanding of what a grammar translation method is going to be and what it looks like in the real classroom, because we have gone through that how the student-teacher interaction is taking place in the classroom. We have understood what the role of teacher is going to be there. We have seen how the language is being viewed. We have seen or we have discussed that how evaluation is also done in a GTM-based classroom. Having appreciated all these things, we also need to underline the limitations of the grammar translation method. We all know that no method is complete in itself. Every method has certain kind of advantages to it, and there are certain kind of limitations, and so does the grammar translation method has. There are explicit grammar rule based teaching. The first important limitation of grammar translation method is that there is explicit grammar rule based teaching. That's the characteristic of grammar translation method, that you are focusing more on the rules. So the teaching is happening on the rule-based idea. Then there is a focus on memorization rather than meaningful learning. So the memorization is focused more, and the teacher and the method is not keeping a focus on that whether the meaningful learning is happening behind that memorization or not. The only premise or the only focus is on memorization. The third limitation of using grammar translation method in the classroom method is speaking and listening skills are ignored. The focus was on reading, writing, vocabulary, and grammar. So the focus, since was placed on all these four skills, this skill of speaking and listening, that was ignored to quite an extent that it becomes a limitation of the method. Another limitation of grammar translation method is that pronunciation is ignored and fluency is also ignored. Now that's going to obviously happen because the listening skills are not being focused on, because the speaking skills are not being focused on. Now if you're not focusing on the speaking and the listening skills, you are definitely going to ignore the pronunciation also and the fluency also. Another limitation of the grammar translation method is no communication or interaction is encouraged among the learners. The student-student interaction is very limited, probably no or very limited or very less number of activities are being done. So the communication or the interaction is not encouraged, not just at the student-student level, even from the student to the teacher. This method is limited in this sense also. So then, because the, see, if you see in the grammar translation method, what is happening is the native language of the class is not changing. The native language of the class is still the spoken language. So the communication would be, whatever communication would be happening in the classroom, that would be happening in the native language. That won't be happening in the foreign language. So communication or interaction is not encouraged in the GTM based classrooms. Then another characteristic limitation of GTM method is that there is teacher oriented classes. We have already discussed the teacher is the dominant figure in the classroom. The student-teacher interaction is limited. The student-student interaction is almost negligible. So this becomes a hardened limitation of the GTM method that this is a teacher dominated classes. Another factor or another limitation of the GTM method is the student's feeling and pace of learning is ignored. Earlier also stated, we are not bothered, the teacher is not bothered with how the student is feeling, and that teacher is not even bothered about the pace of learning. She's coming in, she has to deliver a certain portion, she has to dictate certain rules, and she is moving out. So she is not focusing on the student's feeling and the pace of learning. Also, the students do not have any kind of freedom when it comes to the language practice in the GTM based classrooms, because it's the teacher who is dictating, it's the teacher who is dominating. She's the one who is going to tell what kind of activities are going to be done, what kind of activities are not going to be done in the classroom also. So the students do not enjoy any kind of freedom in language practice also. Then another limitation, and probably one of the striking limitations of the GTM method, is there is focus on accuracy and correctness. So the focus is only on accuracy and correctness. When there is too much focus on accuracy, or for that matter correctness, the focus from innovation goes, or the focus from creativity is moved out. So the students are not in any kind of position that they are going to try something new. Now when you try something new, you are definitely going to make certain kind of mistakes, but you are going to learn much better. But the GTM method absolves all the students of this, any kind of that kind of possibility. There is absolute focus on accuracy and correctness of the language which is being taught. Now I hope you have understood what the grammar translation method looks like. Let's just have a quick recap of the same. Grammar translation method is focusing on grammar and translation. The native language becomes important because that's the language of the classroom, that's a classroom spoken language. The native language is used to explain a foreign language text to the students. A text is being read from the foreign language book and it is explained in the native language to the students. So the teachers are playing an important role here, and probably their most dominant role being played in any kind of classroom is being played by the teachers in the grammar translation method. The students are playing a passive role here. The students do not enjoy that kind of freedom. The native language is the spoken language in the classroom. the teacher is the dominant place in the classroom, and there are certain limitations which are associated with the grammar translation method, in the sense that they are focusing on certain basic skills, they are focusing only on the listening and the speaking skills, and they are not focusing on other skills. Focuses on the accuracy, focuses on the correctness of the language. So, less attention is being paid to the creativity. In fact, no attention is being paid to the creativity in the classroom. The students are being missed. The students' feelings are being missed. Their pace of learning is being ignored. That's all about the grammar translation method. I hope you had an understanding session. Thank you all.